Hello friends, I'm Finder Kumar. I'm taking power electronics for the third year electrical engineering students. Today we will discussing about the DC to DC converter. First we are discussing about the features of the chopper. Chopper is a static device that converts fixed DC input voltage to a variable DC output voltage directly. DC current of an AC transformer as it behaves in an identical manner. More efficient than AC transformers as they involve in one stage conversion. They offer smooth control, high efficiency, fast response and regeneration capacity. A chopper can act as a step up or step down DC chopper. Chopper can be operated in either a continuous or continuous current conduction mode. Continuous and discontinuous, non-continuous current conduction mode. Choppers can be built with or without electrical isolation. They find application in trolley cars, marine hulls, forklifts, foot trucks, and mine rollers. Provide high speed on or off semiconductor switch. It connects source to load and disconnects the load from source at high speed, continuous triggering on and triggering off at rapid switching speed. By varying on and off time of the SCR, the average voltage across the diode, across the load can be varied. These are the elementary principles on which the DC choppers are operating. Next will be the classifications of chopper. Depending upon the direction of the output current and voltage, choppers are classified into five categories. First will be class A chopper, class B chopper, class C chopper, class D chopper, and class E chopper. They are defined on the basis of the one quadrant operation, two quadrant operation, and the four quadrant operation as the class E type chopper. Based on the output voltage, choppers are classified again into four categories: step up boost chopper, step down buck chopper, buck boost chopper, and the cut chopper. Further classification of choppers depending upon the power loss occurred during turn on or off of the switching device. The choppers are classified into two categories. First is the hard switch converter. Here the power loss is high during the switching on to off and off to on. A result of the non-zero voltage and current on the power switches. Second, soft switch or resonant converters. In this type of choppers, the power loss is low at the time of switching as a result of zero voltage and or zero current on the switches. DC to DC converter technology, there will be the linear regulators, switching regulators and charge pumps. DC to DC converter technology are compared like this. On the basis of the parameter, there is the efficiency, there is the EMI noise, output current, boost, step up or step down features, then the solution. For the linear regulator, efficiency is low, EMI noise is low, output current low to medium, boost is no, but step down is possible. Switching regulator, efficiency high, the EMI noise high, output current low to high. Step up yes and step down features yes, but size of the machine will be large. Charge pump having the medium efficiency, medium noise, medium and low output current. Step up and step down features are there, but the size is the medium. Chopper methods of control. The output DC voltage can be varied by the following method: constant frequency control or pulse width modulation PWM control. Next will be the variable frequency control. PWM method in the pulse width turn T on of the output waveform is varied, keeping chopping frequency F and hence chopping period T as a constant. Therefore, output voltage is varied by varying the on time T on. So the output voltage waveform for the different on times. First will be the variable frequency control. In this method of control, chopping frequency is varied, keeping either T on or T off as a constant. This method is also known as frequency modulation. In frequency modulation, to obtain full output voltage and range of frequency has to be varied over a wide range. This method produces harmonics in the output, and for large T off load, current may be discontinuous in nature. This will be the methods of control. Over here, you are finding that there is a possibility of the variation in the variation of the timing. If we are seeing that there is a PWM controller, so at that moment we are finding that the time T, it will be constant, but T on time and off time will be different. Same over here, there is a T on time will be larger as compared to the T off time. So this method is called the PWM controller, where the T will be constant. So T will be constant means it will be 1 upon f equal to 1 upon t, right? So time will be constant, means frequency will be constant, but the on time and off time will be varied. But in case of the variable frequency control, variable frequency control having the time will be changed, means this time and this time will be changed over here. You are finding that the t on, by keeping t on as a constant, it will be constant over here, it is constant over here, but the T of time will be varied. On the variation of the T of time, the total time will be changed. So if we are saying that F equal to 1 upon T, then automatically the frequency of the of this type of arrangement will be varied. So that is the difference between the constant frequency system and the PWM control, PWM, constant frequency or PWM control method, and the variable frequency control method. Thank you.